Working men
Okay, hello Slavoj, channel station marks. What do you think about private property? Should it be abolished or at least limited somehow?
I think that in today's conditions it is too abstract a question, but I agree. I think something that if you look at the critical points that I mentioned already, ecology, new forms of digital control and so on, immigrants and so on, it's not so much, I think, of directly abolishing private property, it's that we need mechanisms which will be relatively global, larger than state, and which will be able to overrun market and state power. That's a question of survival for me. In this sense, I don't want to get into this direct, abstract debate, private property, yes or not. In some sense, if not abolished, yes, it will have to be somehow controlled, limited, whatever you want. You know why? Because it's becoming meaningless. For example, when people praise market, but are people aware to what extent market today, in order to survive, already needs an extremely strong state intervention and so on. It's clear that without strong interventions in every field, like Microsoft or wherever, would already have monopoly. So what I fear more at this level than this individual's private property. I tried to develop this, I'm not sure myself of how economically if this holds or not, but I think what Marx opposed commons and private property. What we are getting today is a new type of wealth, where, and will be some of my books, where commons themselves are privatized in the sense of becoming a corporate property. That's how I explain, for example, this new type of billionaires, Facebook, Microsoft, Amazon, and so on. A private company owns what is really part of our commons, the very network through which we communicate. And that's why at least some economists think like this, and I find it plausible, although I'm not an economist. For example, the next question is, why, how did, now he's no longer the wealthiest man, now it's Jeff Bezos, but how did, let's say, Bill Gates become the richest man in the world? Not by extra exploiting his workers' extra profit. He's charging us a rent, it's a return to rent, for our participation in the commons. For me to exchange emails with you, you have to, it goes through him.
And the internet is the commons?
Yes, the internet is today's commons, yes. And that's for me the crucial question, this privatized commons, but again, it's not simply privatized. Here I appreciate Assange, where he, this is his greatest achievement, I think, when in his book, which is strangely neglected on Google, he provided a nice definition of Google, which is the private corporate version of National Security Agency. What really worries me is this combination between these private companies and the state, some incredible strong power of control and so on, with new forms of exploitation is emerging there. So, yes, I agree with you. In the long term, at least in the role that it has today, private property, something will have to be done with this. And in this sense, to answer your question, I consider myself a communist. In the sense that today we have a certain type, they say neoliberalism. I never liked the word. Because if you look closely, states are effectively, state mechanisms, getting stronger and stronger. Yes, they say in healthcare, state, But if you look at the role of the state, for example, in economy, it's getting stronger and stronger. The formula of today's capitalism is, take mega success stories, not only China, but Singapore and so on. It's always this story of market with the state. So I think that's why the word neoliberalism is deeply deceiving. State is not disappearing today. It's getting stronger and stronger in its economic role and so on and so on. Every American economist will tell you that 100 years ago, even later, only 10% of American industry economy was mediated by state finance, they bought. Today it's already half of it. It's 50. That's why my leftist friends like to refer to Los Angeles as socialist republic of
Los Angeles. It's a communist city almost. Like
sorry?
Communist city like Beijing almost. Financing away.
Yeah, and all connected with state. All the main industries in Los Angeles area are connected with different, it's either health or defense or whatever and so on and so on. So no, in this sense, I am not just this type of democratic socialist in the sense of, you know, a little, maybe, did you notice how these new corporate figures, Mark Zuckerberg, Bill Gates and so on, they all almost perversely now like the term socialist. And it usually means this platitude, you know, like, no, it shouldn't be just egotist capitalism, we need so. No, that's not enough. More radical measures will be needed. And again, the example that I always like to use, my good friend, you should read him, a genius, Theories of Catastrophes, Jean-Pierre Dupuy, D-U-P-U-Y. He told me that he was in Fukushima 2 days after, part of emergency, and he told me that, you know, that for a couple of hours, the Japanese government thought that the radiation will be so strong that they will have to evacuate the entire Tokyo area, 30 million people. Where to put them? How? The rational solution is clear, but you cannot do it without war today. To ask Russia to give parts of Siberia, but you know what I mean? Crises like this will emerge. It's vital to get new forms of international cooperation and so on and so on. So in this sense, the least one can say is that private property will no longer play the structuring role that it does today. Now, liberal bourgeois in the best sense, capitalist, will tell us what is the most efficient form and so on and so on. Oh my God, listen, and with this I conclude, a wonderful story. I read a book, you know how brutally China till 1820s didn't have this type of Western private property. And it wasn't such a failure as we hear now. It was a pretty successful, relatively efficiently run mega state. We know that in 1820, not per capita, but all in all, China was still by far the strongest world economy, twice stronger than United Kingdom. Then comes the catastrophe of the Opium War, which is a scandal. The British were growing opium in Bengal area, selling thousands of tons to the China. Desperate emperor wrote a letter to Queen Victoria and so on, can you prohibit it? The British said no. So out of despair, the emperor prohibited to import British opium because it was destroying his people. You know what happened? The Western powers declared war on China, and it was an obscenity, claiming that free trade is the basis of civilization. If a country limits free trade, in this case, import of drugs, they should be attacked, brought to civilized order. You know what a catastrophe this was for China? In 20, 30 years, China lost half of their whole national brutto product. So you know what's my dream? That would be the truth of liberalism. To solicit today Mexico and to apply the same formula and Colombia, to declare war to United States for limiting the free trade opium in the world. To use the same argumentation. And it's not the same. No. We should stop this fear of. We need. And that's why I don't like this local democracy. You know, we need. No. We need to reinvent somehow larger than state international even cooperation. Without that, we are lost. You may not agree. I don't know. I talk too much. Sorry.
Yeah. I hope we get back to the topic of happiness. I see you're already very happy.
You can go.
I'm always positive.
Thank you, Slavoj.